Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to talk about separation axioms in topological spaces. In particular, I will focus on T0 spaces and T1 spaces. Topological spaces are general structures used to unify various mathematical areas. However, if not supplemented with certain properties, they might lack some desirable features. For example, we may not be able to differentiate points from each other in a topological space, so a sequence could converge to two different limits. Separation axioms are used to distinguish points from points and points from closed sets in topological spaces. Let me begin with the definition of a T0 space. A topological space X is called a T0 space if for any two distinct elements X and Y, there is an open set U such that X belongs to U and Y doesn't belong to U, or Y belongs to U and X doesn't belong to U. Let's look at a figure to understand this property. If we take any two distinct elements X and Y, and there is an open set U that contains X and Y doesn't belong to U, and U contains Y and U doesn't contain X, then X is a T0 space. Next, I'm going to talk about the definition of a T1 space. A topological space X is called a T1 space if for any two distinct elements X and Y, there are two open sets U and V such that X belongs to U and Y doesn't belong to U, and Y belongs to V and X doesn't belong to V. Let's look at another figure to understand this property. We're gonna take any two elements X and Y as long as there are two open sets U and V such that U contains X and U doesn't contain Y, and V contains Y and V doesn't contain X, then the space is T1. It follows directly from the definition that any T1 space is a T0 space, and we're gonna see some examples showing that the converse is not true in general, okay? But let's continue with an equivalent definition of a T1 space. Because of the equal row of X and Y, we can redefine a T1 space as follows. A topological space X is a T1 space if for any two distinct elements X and Y, there is an open set U such that X belongs to U and Y doesn't belong to U. So how come this is equivalent to the previous definition? First of all, let's apply this property for X and Y and see that there is an open set U containing X and U doesn't contain Y. Because of the equal row of X and Y, we can apply this property for Y and X as well. So there is an open set V containing Y and V doesn't contain X. So this property of a T1 space is satisfied, so X is a T1 space. Now, I am going to talk about some examples of T0 spaces, but not T1 spaces. The first one is very simple. Let X be the set consisting of two elements A and B, and let tau be this collection of subsets of X. We can easily verify that tau is a topology on X, and therefore X with tau is a topological space. Now, how come X is not, I'm sorry, how come X is a T0 space, okay? How come X is a T0 space? Let's take two distinct elements in X. They have to be A and B, because A and B are the only two distinct elements in X. Then let U be the single point set. We see that U is open because U belongs to tau, and A belongs to U, sure, and B doesn't belong to U. By definition, X is a T0 space. How come it's not a T1 space? Because we see that there is no open set containing B and it doesn't contain A. Why? Because the only open set containing B is X. There are only three open sets in this topological space, and again, the only open set containing B is X. And X obviously contains A, therefore there is no open set containing B, and it doesn't contain A. Therefore, X is not a T1 space. And this is another example. Let X be R, the real line, and let tau be this collection of X. So an element of tau is either the empty set or any set that contains the origin 0. We can show that tau is a topology on X, and therefore X with tau is a topological space. How come it is T0? Let's prove it. Let's take any two distinct elements X and Y. First, consider the case where X is 0 or Y is 0. For example, if X is 0, then let U be this single point set 0. It contains X and it's open because it contains 0, okay? And Y doesn't belong to U because Y is non-zero. Remember that X and Y are distinct. And it is similar for the case where Y is 0. Now, consider the case where both X and Y are non-zero. Let U be this set, the set consisting of X and 0. Then it's open, it contains X. How come it's open? Because it contains 0, okay? And Y doesn't belong to the set U. Therefore, by definition, X is a T0 space. You can also show by the definition that this is not a T1 space, but we're gonna revisit this property after the next theorem. This is a very nice characterization for T1 spaces. A topological space X is T1 if every single point set in this topological space is closed. Wow, nice. How can we prove this property? The proof is quite straightforward. Perhaps I'm gonna prove the converse implication and leave this forward implication for you as an exercise, okay? To prove the converse implication, we assume that every single point set in this topological space is closed. So now we're gonna take two distinct elements X and Y, and let U be this set, it's the complement of this single point set, and V is the complement of this single point set. Then U and V are open, X belongs to U. How come they are open? Because they are complements of two closed sets. Again, they are the complements of two closed sets, because again, every single point set is closed. X belongs to U, obvious, because X and Y are distinct. Y belongs to U, Y doesn't belong to U, okay, by its definition. Y belongs to V, again, because Y and X are distinct. And Y belongs to V, okay, and X doesn't belong to V, okay. Therefore, X is a T1 space. Now, let's revisit the previous example. In this example, this is not a T1 space because we can find a single point set that is not closed. Say, let's take this set, the set 0, okay? It contains only 0. Its complement doesn't contain 0. Okay, so its complement is not open. Therefore, this set is not closed. And it is a single point set. So this is not a T1 space. Okay. That's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. In the next video, I am going to talk about Hausdorff or T2 space and also T3 space. Okay. So hope to see you again in the next video. Thank you.